Good evening, I'm Haley Wilkes.
And I'm Scott Dennis, thanks for being with us tonight.
Our top story this evening, the cleanup from Tropical Storm Emily continues. Damages in Manatee County now estimated to be at least $100,000.
Now, 2 days later, residents and business owners are still assessing all that damage. ABC 7's Jess Dowdrick has the story.
The National Weather Service was out here in Manatee County surveying all of the damage. They confirmed that a tornado did touch down, wind speeds reaching up to 80 miles an hour, leaving damage more than a mile long.
Oh, kind of find a little bit more every time you walk around.
Marty Orban is finding new property damage every day after his nursery found itself in the middle of a devastating tornado's path during Tropical Storm Emily.
The biggest issue to me right now is the plastic on the greenhouses. We probably lost half to two-thirds of the plastic.
Each roll of plastic costs $500, plus the labor to install it. Orban says his staff doesn't have enough time to do it alone, with poinsettia season right around the corner. Then there's the barn. That's all but completely gone.
We got one estimate of like $34,000 to rebuild it, something like that.
Orban estimates well over $100,000 in damages to the nursery. Countywide, emergency management is still surveying the damage.
Just from the tornado itself, the damages were estimated at well over, I think it was $96,000 to $98,000. And then they're still coming in because that was just preliminary.
The damage was not extensive enough to call for declarations for state or federal funding. So for Marty Orban, those $100,000 will all come out of pocket.
He didn't have insurance. The greenhouses, I haven't been able to get insurance in a long time. And I think a lot of it has to do that we're close to the water.
But there is one silver lining.
Lucky enough, there were no injuries of any kind.
Now, as far as Sarasota is concerned, the county says that they do not have any cost estimates when it comes to storm damage from Emily. They say that the county never made it out of the monitoring phase. Reporting in Manatee County, Jess Dowdrick, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Thank you, Jess. The storm also causing some damage to a Manatee County park. The DeSoto National Memorial is closed due to falling debris, tree limbs, and tidal surge. The tropical storm spawned a tornado in northwest Bradenton, where the memorial is located.
We were hit very hard by Tropical Storm Emily. We had upwards of 60 to 70 mile per hour wind gusts that went through the park and possibly even a mini cyclone. That blew down lots of different types of debris, branches, actually, and even fell several trees in and around our headquarters and visitor center area, and as well as our park trails.
You hear the chainsaws going there. Rangers say there's also some flooding at the park. Crews from Canaveral National Seashore are at the park today and tomorrow to help remove all that debris. The park will remain closed until further notice.
Historic pool back open for business. The Lido Beach pool opening back up today. It was closed for about 2 weeks after lightning struck the pool. The electrical panel, which controls the pumps and chemical levels, that was damaged. Crews had to fix it. The pool is located next to the Lido Beach Pavilion and right next to the beach.
Yeah, and I guess you needed it earlier today, didn't you?
Yeah, you did, because it was quite steamy. Let's head over to Bob and get more on that.
You can just feel it. The humidity is way back up. That dryer that had been in place has moved northward now. Here's a look at 2 p.m. You can see some high clouds around, but notice what happens as I put the map into motion there, or video into motion. You can see clouds start to increase from the Gulf of Mexico, and then a tremendous amount of rain for a short period of time moves on in. And guess what? There's more on the way for parts of the Suncoast. Get a look at it now. We had all this dry, clear sky earlier. That has since moved to the east. And now a line of showers and storms developing along what is a trough of low pressure now. And that's good news. It's not a centralized area of circulation. But look at all this rainfall now near Osprey, just north of Venice, stretching off toward Lakewood Ranch. This is all moving rapidly to the northeast at around 30 miles an hour. But notice the showers and storms themselves aren't dropping south or north at this point. These just kind of flared up, and they continue to move off to the northeast. And look at this, a big area of rainfall. And this is what is known as training effect. These showers may pass over the same area for the next couple of hours. Flooding is a real possibility. Well, more on that coming up in just a few minutes. Back to you.
Thank you, Bob. An update tonight on a fatal crash in Northport. Police are now releasing the name of the victim. He's been identified as 54-year-old Brian Nagel. The accident happened about a week and a half ago on I-75. Nagel was driving northbound when his car went off the roadway into the grass, then struck a guardrail before going into the southbound lanes. He was pronounced dead at the scene. An investigation is still ongoing.
New tonight at 5, Sarasota police need your help to catch a car burglar. Surveillance video shows the person going into an unlocked vehicle along Seidel Street and stealing money from a purse inside the vehicle. Anyone with information about this or the person in the video can call Sarasota police, and police are again reminding people to lock their vehicles.
A traffic stop turned into a police chase that ended with an arrest in Sarasota. The Sarasota County Sheriff's Office booking 61-year-old Isa Allian on aggravated battery and stalking charges. Deputies say they attempted to stop him in a parking lot while he was picking up a woman who was waiting for him. Then he sped off. Deputies chased him along Weber Street in Sarasota. He eventually stopped in a neighborhood on Tuxford Drive. A witness tells ABC7 that he was a bit shaken up over this.
When I peeked out through the drapes, I saw about a dozen police cars with all their lights flashing straight down my street. When I analyzed the situation, it looked like that car could have come right through my bedroom and hit me.
Luckily, that did not happen. Allian is also charged with fleeing to elude officers. The woman who was the passenger in the car was released.
An update tonight on a former golf club in Northport.
After sitting vacant for 3 years, the former Sable Trace Golf and Country Club has been auctioned off. The property was sold to a so far unnamed buyer for $2.97 million. It was novel. There were plans to build a replica 18-hole golf course, complete with holes that matched some of the best from around the world. Instead, the course closed in May of 2015. The course was never redeveloped and was finally put into foreclosure last year. We'll have more on this story coming up tonight at 6.
A Suncoast group is looking to make our area more appealing to college students. The Consortium of Colleges on the Creative Coast is changing its branding. It'll now be known as Cross College Alliance. The group is a collaboration of the Sarasota Manatee Region's colleges and universities. College leaders meet to explore ways their institutions can partner up and share resources. The name change comes as the alliance works to make the Suncoast more college-friendly for students.
We like to see ourselves as the campus of the Cross College Alliance. And so we do a number of programs that are directly targeted at the college age community here, because we want them to feel a sense of community, and we want them to stay.
Cross College Alliance started about 2 years ago. It includes 6 colleges in Sarasota and Manatee counties, as well as 1 in St. Petersburg. Still to come tonight in your Suncoast News, a close call with Mother Nature for an airport worker in Southwest Florida. I'll show you the footage of a lightning bolt that sends co-workers running for cover.
And ABC 7 Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan will be back with your full weather forecast for the rest of the evening. And in Health Smart, if you're not overweight or obese, could you be over fat? A look at what that means and why it's risky for your health.
For the last 18 years, Samantha's Friends has been assisting people along the Suncoast who have been challenged by catastrophic illnesses or affected by autism obtain a service canine. We need your help. Please show your support by attending our annual Celebrity Gala brunch and fundraiser. Call Sammy Lee at 941-448-8558 for more information.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
Are you currently on Medicare? In other words, do you carry the red, white, and blue Medicare card? If so, are you suffering from chronic back pain? If you answered yes, you may be eligible for a pain-relieving back brace covered by Medicare at little to no cost, shipped directly to your home for free. These medical-grade back braces are ideal for lower back pain, arthritis, spinal disorders, and other chronic back problems. Will you qualify for a medical-grade back brace?
Call Back Brace America at 1-800-683-9262.
Being the caregiver for someone you love is truly a blessing, but sometimes you can lose a part of yourself. To be your best, for them and for you, it's important to have time to be able to recharge your batteries. When you call Tidewell Hospice, they can give you a chance to do just that, and with the peace of mind of knowing your loved one is in the very best hands. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Oh, look! A bouquet of lump-livered drolls.
We went to a real school to show that bullying should be history.
You monkey-elbowed pockmarks. What a bunch of beef-witted pig nuts.
On Monday, October 2nd, let's all stand up for World Day of Bullying Prevention by rocking a blue shirt. Together, let's make bullying a thing of the past. Go blue and get your blue shirt at stompoutbullying.org.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7.
We have scarce resources, and at this particular time, we've decided that we really need to reinvest in the fire department.
After years of neglect, the Venice Fire Department is literally falling apart. What is the city's plan? Will it take a tax hike to get a new firehouse? I'm Alan Cohn. We'll ask the city and the fire department.
Tonight on ABC 7 News at 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
Developing tonight, record-setting temperatures in the Northwest. Some places are shattering previous records by more than 10 degrees.
And the temperatures are quickly raising health and utility concerns. ABC's Marcy Gonzalez explains.
A possible historic heat wave in the Northwest. Temperatures shattering records. Redding, California suffering through the all-time hottest day ever there, 113 degrees. Portland forecasted to hit 107 degrees. There, people and animals are doing their best to stay cool.
We really are trying to make it a comfortable space for them to be in when it is so warm.
Seattle could also reach triple-digit temperatures, which has only happened three times in the past 123 years. Officials warning of the danger of heat stroke, especially since only about 15% of homes there have air conditioning. No surprise that across the Northwest, ACs are now a hot commodity.
Today it's been swamped. We've sold about 130 or 140 pieces of air conditioners.
Cooling centers are open while other people head for the malls, pools, and anywhere they can take a dip.
Being out in the water is great and cool off and get in the shade. Yeah.
Searching for some relief, which is hard to come by for firefighters. Battling at least 48 wildfires fueled by these extreme temperatures.
And the heat is not letting up, with triple-digit temperatures in the forecast in parts of the Northwest for at least the next few days. Marcy Gonzalez, ABC News, Los Angeles.
Here in Florida, surveillance video captures the moment an airport worker gets electrocuted by a lightning bolt. The footage shows at least three workers backing a plane up for takeoff. One man, seen in the yellow, directs the front of the plane, and the other man, Austin Dunn, is seen in orange, ducking under the plane's wing. That's when the bolt, as you saw right there, struck the plane's tail, traveling through the fuselage and right into Dunn's body, causing him to collapse immediately. Dunn suffered third-degree burns and some also bleeding in his brain. Wow, but he's expected to be okay. The incident happened this past Saturday at Southwest Florida International Airport in Fort Myers. No other planes or workers were out in the storm at that time.
Apparently went into one hand, threw his body, and then out the other. Yeah.
Yeah, look like it spread through the ground through them too. Yeah. So again, planes are rather safe. You know, a lot of planes get hit by lightning all the time. They can transfer that energy. You saw it right there, missing the plane's interior and traveling down through the tire. There looks like lightning just hit at 2 o'clock this afternoon in Pinellas County. It hit a utility pole and it knocked it down. And then the lightning caused a water main break on top of that. So it went down to the ground and blew the water pipe out. That just happened in St. Petersburg, up there near St. Petersburg. So not many lightning strikes around right now in our area, but a lot of rainfall setting up too to be kind of a wet night for places here along the Sun Coast. Not everyone's going to see it, but KCK webcam showing that line of showers moving in throughout this late afternoon. Took its time getting here, but it finally has moved in, and that's a result of a low pressure area in the Gulf of Mexico. Really, it's a line of low pressure, if you will. The weather headlines read like this: the potential for a tropical low developing out there is small at this point. In fact, the National Hurricane Center are not even looking at it anymore. Rip current advisory in effect, though, due to that onshore flow and some heavy rain through this evening in parts of the Sun Coast. Not everyone's going to get it. A little drier air starts to move in on Friday, so we're still going to get some rainfall tomorrow, too. Get a look at what's setting up. A lot of moisture out here in the Gulf of Mexico. This line of low pressure, if you will, extends all the way through much of the western portions of the Gulf. And now that moisture continues to ride into west central Florida. Into Anna Maria Island, it's ended for the most part as far as that heavy rain. It was around earlier, and that storm that moved through Pinellas County did bring wind gusts up to 40 miles an hour at Fort DeSoto. And then into eastern Manatee County, some heavy rainfall there. Again, the storms are moving rather quickly off to the northeast at 30 miles an hour. The thing that's got me a little concerned is the fact that this line now just kind of flared up last hour or so, and now it continues to work its way off to the northeast, and it looks like we could see the possibility of some training event where repeated showers move over the same area over the next hour or so. So we'll keep an eye on these. Hopefully these will die down a little bit. But as far as the distance goes from Osprey, you can see this line set up all the way about 50 miles offshore. And it's going to take a couple of hours for that line to get on in. And then there's another area of large area of some light to moderate precipitation occurring out in the Gulf of Mexico. So it's not over yet. The possibility of some localized flooding exists through tonight and tomorrow as a result of just a tremendous amount of moisture in the atmosphere. Right now, some rain falling at the Sarasota Brady Airport at 78, and the dew point is at 74. Winds are out of the west at 10, the pressure 30.07 inches. Where it's rained, it's cooled down considerably into the mid-70s now in Jacksonville, Orlando. Upper 70s here in Sarasota, Tallahassee now at 90. Well, the future cast indicating that the rain will be around through this evening, but tapering off by midnight, we'll start to see some breaks in the action. But then, with this trough still around, a good chance for some showers and storms in the morning, a little less action, I think, later on in the day on Thursday. Well, the national satellite scene showing some showers, a little system moving through parts of the mid-Mississippi Valley and also into the Ohio Valley right now, cooling down over the northern plain states. And in the tropics, all is quiet now. Things are looking much better with that system as it's being sheared apart, some dry air to the north, so this tropical wave, not much of a chance developing over the next several days. We'll keep an eye on it, though, as it enters into the Caribbean early next week. 72 in Boston right now, 89 in the nation's capital. Hot there, but Minot, North Dakota, 66 degrees. Denver, it's 87, 78 in Dallas now. And the heat we just showed you is going on out into California and out west. South winds turn to the southwest at 10 knots. A light chop on the bays and inland waters. The water temperature now is an 88 degree temperature now. The UV index tomorrow will be a 7. High tide at 12:01, sunset at 8:18. The forecast tonight, scattered showers, a few thunderstorms. Some of that rain could be heavy, and not everyone's going to see the rain that they're seeing now in South Sarasota County. Variable clouds tomorrow and 50% chance for storms, a high of 89. The extended forecast calls for a little less action on Friday with the rain chance at 30%, and we are looking for, again, the rain chance at 30%. We'll get back to that a little bit, that 7-day forecast, in just a little bit. Back to you, Scott.
Nice waves there, though. Yeah. Down in Suncoast Traffic Watch, rush hour traffic is picking up a little bit in Manatee County. We're seeing congestion along US 301 in the north and southbound lanes. Also, some backup on State Road 70 in the area of Lockwood Ridge State Road, and then State Road 64 as well. No crashes reported in the area. We're also seeing the northbound lanes of I-75 a bit congested from, looks like, State Road 70 north as you approach Ellenton. Southbound lanes, though, all green at this hour. Haley.
Thank you, Scott. In health news tonight, hot car deaths have reached record numbers. So far this year, 29 children have died of heat stroke after being left in a vehicle. That is more than at this point in previous years. That's according to the Department of Meteorology and Climate Science at San Jose State University, which tracks these numbers yearly. 11 of those deaths were reported in just the past week. The previous record as of July 31st was 28 deaths in 2010. Those who track these statistics say the actual number is probably higher each year because not all hot car deaths are reported. Americans are feeling more joyful this year than last, but the majority still aren't happy. The 2017 Harris Poll survey of American happiness shows only 33% of Americans surveyed said they were happy. In 2016, it was a slightly smaller 31% of Americans. Men and women in high-income households and those with a high school diploma or less reported being the happiest. One of the biggest jumps involved faith. 71% of Americans said their spiritual beliefs were a positive guiding force, compared to just 66% in 2016. If you're not overweight or obese, could you be overfat? Overfat is a term created to describe a body fat level that can actually hurt your health. This could apply to you even if your body mass index falls in the normal range. A study published in Frontiers in Public Health suggests BMI misses about 50% of the people who still have dangerous amounts of fat. The hallmark of being overfat is having an excess of fat in dangerous places, specifically your belly. Abdominal fat wraps around your vital organs, which means cholesterol can sneak into your arteries. It can also raise your blood sugar and inflammation levels. Coming up next, tragedy at a private Christian school when part of the building collapses after a natural gas explosion. Plus, how a one-eyed bald eagle gets a much-needed helping hand from two lobstermen in Maine. Those stories when we come back.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Credit card debt can ruin your life. If you owe $10,000 and minimum payments are siphoning away your paycheck each month, you can get debt-free in less time than you think.
I've paid $800 a month for the past 3 years and haven't changed the balance on my credit card.
Get Debt-Free Now has a program to reduce your debt, stop the harassing phone calls, avoid financial ruin, and settle for less than you owe.
I feel like a huge weight has been lifted off my shoulders.
You're pre-approved for our special hardship program if you owe $10,000 or more. Upon payment of your new lower balance, your debt will finally shrink until you are debt-free.
My family no longer has 30 years of payments ahead of us at 20% interest.
There's no fees until you see results. So call now, make one monthly program payment and free up your cash. Resolve your debt.
Call 800-628-1251. 800-628-1251.
Consumer Cellular makes it easy to stay in touch with family and stay within our budget.
Now our cell phone bill is only a fraction of what it used to be.
Our average customers get everything they need for about $25 a month, and plans start at only $10 a month with no contracts.
Consumer Cellular has a great choice of phones.
Check out my new one.
I picked this simple phone.
I use my son's old smartphone. Kept my number, too.
Consumer Cellular has been an approved AARP provider since 2008, and members get exclusive discounts.
It's a good thing Consumer Cellular is always there, because sometimes I need a little help.
Sometimes. We're proud to have received the J.D. Power Award for highest customer service among non-contract wireless providers.
Over the years, we've seen a lot of change.
We actually use change.
Luckily, there are some things we can still afford.
Like Consumer Cellular.
Stop paying too much for wireless service. Switch now, and for a limited time, get a $20 credit on any new line of service. Call 1-800-920-3084. Go online or visit a Target store today.
Are you Goodwill?
Yes, because when I donate
or shop at Goodwill,
I'm creating a job.
I am Goodwill, yeah, yeah.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.
One person is dead, another unaccounted for after an explosion and partial building collapse at a prep school in Minneapolis.
Three people were rescued from the school's roof. Crews are now searching for one other person who they believe is buried in the rubble. Seven others are in the hospital, three in critical condition. The explosion is believed to have been caused by a ruptured gas line.
A freight train, Carrie, has hazardous materials that derails this morning, sparking a fire that burned for hours. It happened about 100 miles outside of Pittsburgh. At least 32 cars derailed and crashed into a home. This was about 5 o'clock in the morning. One car contained liquefied petroleum gas. Another had molten sulfur. No one was hurt. Everyone who lived within a half mile of the site, they all had to be evacuated. Health officials are now conducting air and ground studies to determine possible health effects.
A teenager is lucky to be alive after jumping from an airplane last night. Witnesses on board the Copa Airlines flight in California say the 17-year-old boy opened the emergency exit door, jumped onto one of the plane's wings, and then slid down onto the tarmac.
The people next to him, they seemed pretty surprised when he jumped. So I don't think he was like giving too many like warning signs that he was going to do that.
The teen is a U.S. citizen and was traveling alone. It's unclear why he decided to jump.
It was a Jaws-like close encounter for a cameraman in Massachusetts while filming underwater footage for great white sharks in the Atlantic. One of these sharks swims right up, and starts chomping on the camera. The GoPro video shows the 12-foot shark's teeth and the wrinkles of its tongue. Take a look at this. Wow. Oh, the cameraman says this is a common incident that comes with the territory of his job. The man works for the Atlantic White Shark Conservancy.
A pair of lobstermen in Maine save a one-eyed bald eagle from drowning. The men spotted the bird struggling in the Atlantic, so they fashioned a makeshift raft out of a bait tank cover and a life preserver and used it to bring the bird on board. They intended on taking the eagle to wildlife officials, but it had other plans. After it had rested a while, it just flew away. One of the lobstermen says it was the most incredible thing that has ever happened to him.
I can imagine. I have never seen video like that. Yeah. Just of an eagle swimming. Oh.
I don't think they have the oils in their feathers that a lot of other mm-hmm. water birds have. So if they get wet, you know,
they're waterlogged. Right. Well, I hope he's okay. Still to come on your Suncoast News, a dramatic change to the country's immigration system.
Plus, a new high-tech way to protect your identity on the road. Details about Florida's newest driver licenses and when we come back.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.
This is an important medical announcement. Bard IVC filters have been linked to punctured veins and problems with migration. Anyone who's received a Bard IVC filter must receive medical monitoring and may be entitled to substantial compensation. If you have the Bard Recovery G2 or G2 Express filter, you are in a class of patients who should be compensated for some expenses. Call now for a free assessment of your case and potential money damages. This call is confidential. There's no cost and you may be eligible. Juries have awarded millions of dollars to people who should have been warned about the risks of the Bard IVC filters. Call the IVC filter hotline if you or a loved one has received an IVC filter and experienced a vein puncture or required medical monitoring. You must call now.
Call 800-329-3089. 800-329-3089.
Because my parents told me I have to be responsible.
Because my first coach told me, you can do this.
Because my boss showed me how to do a good job.
Because my teacher helped me see the choices.
I'm swimming faster than I ever dreamed.
I am a valuable employee.
I discovered that I could work as an artist.
I will be whatever I want to be.
Youth with disabilities should grow up expecting to work and succeed. For more information, visit whatcanyoudocampaign.org.
Students on the Suncoast are heading back to school, and we want to make sure local kids have the supplies they need to succeed. If you'd like to donate, or if you're a family in need, join us here at the Boys and Girls Club of Sarasota this Saturday at 10 o'clock for the Back to School Backpack Brigade. ABC7 is teaming up with the Tiny Hands Foundation to fill hundreds of backpacks with with supplies for local children in need. For more information on how you can help, go to tinyhandsfoundation.org/backpack-brigade.
Thanks to my volunteer, I am a better eater.
Thanks to my volunteer, math seems simple now.
Thanks to my volunteer, I discovered new career goals.
I'm a volunteer for Sarasota County Schools, so I know I can make a difference. And you can too. Give an hour, change a life.
Now's the perfect time to work with California Closets. During our Shades of White event, save up to 20% on our beautiful white finishes for any space in your home. Contact us today for your free design consultation. Visit our showroom or online at californiaclosets.com.